Hey guys, welcome back. Today I'll be doing my June favorites. I know I'm a little late on this one, but I have a few things to share with you guys. And as usual, I have a billion lip options. So let's quickly get started. I don't really use eyeshadows on a daily basis, but whenever I do, I like to use brown shades or like nude colors. And the one that I've been using the most is this one by P.A.C. I got it a few months back, I think, or a few weeks back. I don't really remember. This is in the number 7 and it's a beautiful matte warm brown. And I like to use this by itself. I just put a little bit on my entire lid and do like a really thick winged liner, and it looks really, really nice. So next I have two brushes. One I really like and one I don't like so much. So both of them are by P.A.C. This one is $3.49 and it's a very nice dome brush. I like to use this to set my under eyes, and I also like to use this for touch-ups. And it's a very nice brush. It packs on enough product and it's very inexpensive. So the next brush is the $3.79. Now when I was buying this, the guy told me that I have to like put foundation in the center on that tiny sponge over there and use the brush for blending it out. I tried it out with a few different formulas. It did not work. I used it with a powder foundation and it does a really good job, but I feel that I don't really need that sponge thingy in the center if I have to just use it for powder. And it's a pain to clean that. Like, I tried cleaning it a few times and you can still see the foundation on it, so I don't really know how to clean this. And it's a little expensive. I think this was like 800 rupees, whereas I think he had other brushes that were similar and cheaper, so I'm a little disappointed with this. I think I mentioned this in a haul video a few months back. This is Colorbar's Lighten Up Lip Mender. So while buying this, the lady at the store was telling me that this will help lighten my lips and fill in the lines. I don't really know about the lightening bit and the line filling bit, but it does work as a primer. But as a lip balm or a lip treatment, it doesn't really do much. Or maybe it's just my lips, I don't know, because I've read other reviews of people where they really like this product, so maybe it's just me. But this is a great product if you have problems with your lipstick bleeding, but it does change the texture of matte lipsticks a little bit. Like if you're wearing a very dry lipstick, it makes it a little more satiny, which is great because it makes it a little more flexible for your lips. But if you're going for that full-on matte look, then this will alter the texture. You want to keep that in mind before buying this. So I was looking for a good drugstore toner and I found this one. This is by Neutrogena. Neutrogena makes really good skincare products. This is their Deep Clean Blackhead Eliminating Cooling Toner. This is great if you have oily skin. I would recommend that you use this only on oily areas. I used this on my entire face and I have combination skin. So certain parts of my face are a little more sensitive than the other parts. Like my T-zone is oily and the rest of my face is dry. And for some reason, my left cheek has a lot of open pores, so I tend to break out more on the left side of my face. So I like using this only on my T-zone. It does control the oil. It has a little bit of scent. It will sting a little bit. But if you're in the market for like a good affordable toner, then you should definitely give this a go. Next, I have two lip oils. This is by Lancome and this is by Clinique. Now, I remember mentioning that I like the Clinique one better than the Lancome one, but they are actually quite different. The Clinique is more pigmented and more like a jelly. It is more like a lip stain. You can also use this on your cheeks. And the Lancome one is more of a lip treatment. They both have a very pretty color payoff and they smell great. Like the Clinique one does not have any scent, but the Lancome one smells like cherries. Also, the packaging is so cute. They've done a really good job with the packaging. And finally, I have four lip products. So this one is by Lakme. It's from their Enrich Satin line. And this is in the number 651. It's actually a mood changing lipstick. It does not have a color, but it adapts to your body's pH level and it turns into like a really nice pink. And this is how the bullet looks. It's just an orange lipstick. The next one is a beautiful red color from Colorbar. It's called Red, She Said, and this is in number 002. It's a very pretty maroonish red color and it's matte. This is very similar to MAC's Viva Glam 1. And here's a quick swatch. And the last two are liquid lipsticks. This one is from Chambord. It's their Extreme Wear Transfer Proof Liquid Lipstick. This is in the shade 481. It's a very pretty nude color. By itself, this kind of washes me out a little bit. So I actually bought this to mix up with some of my other liquid lipsticks and lighten them. My favorite combination has been this with my Colorbar Kiss Proof Lip Stain in the number 004 Blush Crush. You can customize this according to your choice and, you know, create multiple shades of the same color. I love doing that and I've been doing that for a while now. I'll show you guys a quick swatch of how I actually do it so you guys can see. So those were all my favorite products for the month. I will be talking about a video that I really like. It's a video of a panda. And there's this lady who is like cleaning the cage and this panda is constantly going and like troubling her, and it's such a cute video. I really love pandas and I'll have that video linked down below for you guys to check out. And I'll also have my favorite song. I'll make a small playlist for you guys and have that also linked down below. And I don't really remember who, but someone recommended that I should start watching Doctor Who in my Q&A video when I said that I was very fascinated with aliens. Someone told me that I should start watching Doctor Who, and I started watching Doctor Who and I'm obsessed with the show. I really like the 11th Doctor, he's so cute. And yep, those were all the things that I've been loving for this month. And let me know in the comments below what were your favorites. If you have anything in specific that you want me to try, I would love to try it out. Also, make sure you follow me on Snapchat. I did a small rant on Snapchat yesterday and today. If you want to see that, you can actually check out my Snapchat and follow me on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook. Did I miss something? I'm pretty sure I missed something. I'll have them all linked down below, guys. Also, please give this video a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already. And check out some of my other videos over there and over there. You can click them or they'll all be linked down below. That's it for now, guys. I'll see you all very soon. Bye-bye.